डियर लर्नर्स, वेलकम अगेन टू आवर ऑनलाइन क्लास एवेंस बाय सिटी कॉमन्स गर्ल्स हाई स्कूल चट्टग्राम। आई एम अंजना बरुआ, असिस्टेंट टीचर, सिटी कॉमन्स गर्ल्स हाई स्कूल चट्टग्राम। डियर लर्नर्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेल एंड हार्टी। आई एम ऑल्सो सो। आई थिंक यू कैन रिमेम्बर दैट इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टार्टेड विथ चेंजिंग सेंटेंस एंड वी स्टार्टेड विथ एफर्मेटिव टू negative and we have also completed some rules. Today we will complete the lesson affirmative to negative. So let us start our today's lesson. Take your notebook, let us start. Okay, continue the class attentively. So today's first rule is rule number 9. Sometimes we get modal auxiliary verb must in affirmative sentences, then we have to use cannot, but, or cannot help plus verb plus ing to make the affirmative sentence into negative. Let us see an example. He must remember it. In negative, he, we can use cannot but or cannot help. So in this example, we will use cannot but. He cannot but remember it. We will see another example. We must obey our parents. Here we will use cannot help, cannot help verb plus ing, obeying our parents. Here dear learners, in first example we have used cannot but instead of must, that's why there is no change for the verb. But in second one we have used cannot help instead of must, that's why we have to use the present participle form for verbs. So we have to remember that if there is a modal auxiliary verb must in an affirmative sentence, we can use cannot but or cannot help for instead of must to change the sentence into negative. But when we will use cannot but, there will be no change for the verb. But when we will use cannot help, we have to use the main verb in present participle form to make the sentence negative. So dear learners, I think it is clear to you. Come to the next rule, rule number 10. Sometimes it's an adverb. We can get this adverb in an affirmative sentence. We have to use not plus always to make the affirmative sentence into negative. Let us see an example. I sometimes go there. In negative, notice dear learners, here there is no helping verb in this sentence. There is no auxiliary verb, that's why we have to use an auxiliary verb to make the sentence negative. We have to use auxiliary verb depending on the number and person of the subject of the sentence and the tense of the sentence. Here we can get that the subject of this sentence is first person singular number, and the sentence is in simple present tense. That's why we will use the auxiliary verb do to make the sentence negative. I do not go. I do not always go there. So, dear learners, I think it is clear to you. We will see another example also, where we will get an helping verb. A rich man is sometimes happy. In negative, a rich man is not always happy. Dear learners, look at the example. Here is an auxiliary verb is, or helping verb is, be verb is. That's why we don't need to use another auxiliary verb. So that's why we are we directly use the auxiliary verb. A rich man is not always happy. Okay, dear learners, come to the next rule. Rule number 11. Both dot dot and or simple and. If there is both dot dot and or simple and, we have to use not only dot dot but also to make the affirmative sentence negative. For example, both I and Sumona went there. Here we have to use not only but also both instead of both, not only I instead of and, I will use but also Sumona went there. Dear learners, look at the example. Here we have to use not only instead of both and but also instead of and to make the sentence negative. Here so the negative one is not only I but also Sumona went there. So let us see another example. She took meat and fish. In negative, we will use not only but also she took not only meat but also fish. So dear learners, here we can see that there is not a single and, so we have to use she took not only meat but also fish. Okay, dear learners, come to the next rule. Rule number 12. A little. When we get a little, In an affirmative sentence, we have to use not much to make the sentence negative. For example, I have a little water. In negative, we have to use I have not a little, instead of a little, I will use not much water. So, dear learners, in this example, we have to use a little, instead of a little, we not much to make the sentence negative. So, dear learners, come to the next rule. If there is much in an affirmative sentence, you have to use not a little in to make the sentence negative. If there is much in an affirmative, the word much in the affirmative sentence, we have to use not a little to make the sentence negative. For example, he has much money. We have to use not a little to make it negative. He has not a little money. So, dear learners, you can see that in the example we get the word much. He has much money. For making it negative, we have to use not a little instead of much. He has not a little money. Not a little money. Okay, dear learners, come to the next rule, and this is the last one, rule number 14. When you will get the universal truth or a proverb in an affirmative sentence, you have to use negative interrogative to make the sentence negative. Let us see the example. Old is gold. Negative, it's an proverb, old is gold. That's why we have to use a negative interrogative to make the sentence negative. For making it negative interrogative, we have to take the help of this auxiliary verb. Isn't old gold? Let us see another example. The earth moves round the sun. Dear learners, there is no auxiliary verb or helping verb in this sentence. That's why we have to use auxiliary verb. Here, the main verb is moves. That's why we will use does to make it negative. So that would be doesn't. The earth move round the sun. So, dear learners, we can see that in the first example there is a proverb, that's why we have to use the negative interrogative to make the affirmative sentence negative, and at the same way there is an universal truth in the second example, that's why we have to use negative interrogative to make the sentence the affirmative sentence negative. Okay dear learners, that's all. There are another some other rules to make the affirmative sentence into negative one. Those rules are almost related to the adjective or degree of adjective. You will there isn't use of degree of adjective in class 7, that's why I have avoided the rules. To understand the rules, you have to understand the rules of degree of adjective. That's why you will get the rules in the higher classes from class 8 or 9, 10. So dear learners, let us take our homework based on these rules. Take your notebook again and write down the homework. Number one, man must submit to destiny. Number two, I sometimes come here. Number three, both Rana and Joshim are good neighbors. Good neighbors. Number four, they have a little money. Number five, the son gives us light. Number six, he has much name and fame. Okay, dear learners, I think you will do the homework at your home and do not forget to send a pic of the homework to the Facebook page of our school. Let us meet again in our next class. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.